Hello everybody, this is Nintendo 14. Playthrough on Pikmin. What? We already did everything there is to do in this game, except for a few things. For one, there's a challenge mode, which I will go over in a bit, because I didn't get to show this off in my original playthrough of this game. And also there's another thing that I want to also show off that I never got to do. And that's what happens if we reached all the way to day 30 and not collect all the ship parts. I'm also playing this on the Wii, courtesy of Gamefly. I was able to rent this game for the day I'm recording this. So here's what the day rewind thing is like. Just push minus or plus. This only works on the Wii re-release. So you can't do this on the GameCube version, but for right now, let's go 1 month after the initial site of impact. And let's just see what exactly happens when we don't get all the ship parts. It says I have 28 out of 30, but it'd be pretty funny on the one, or except for the unnecessary ship parts, but it'll be pretty funny to see this one ship part that I won't be including into my ship. Yep, there it is. I'm really confident that we can take off without my good old pilot seat. Picturing this in the cockpit, images of me lifting off into space begin with to fill my text brain. Fills me with inspiration once again. But you know, it just doesn't fit, because the way I rebuilt this ship is so that way it doesn't fit. And I'm not... Oh. What? I can't just go to sunset. Well, I guess I gotta wait then. Ugh, didn't plan this out, did I? But I guess, what I could do is, just take damage over and over from somewhere. So, while I go ahead and just, knock myself down, because that is a way where you can, just end the day automatically, is just, getting hurt, and didn't mean to go up there, but yeah, I guess I can go into my little experience with Gamefly. It's a really, really nice service. You can just rent, and as advertised, you can just rent games on the online, and oh, right. It's fine. You can rent games, or so you can rent games. I'm not getting. It's just that. First off, let's just not say that I'm not being paid to say all of these things, but I'm really liking how Gamefly is, and that's how it's like to have Olimar go down. Day automatically ends, but in my advice, if you're gonna use Gamefly, try to rent as many games as you can. If that means to speed run games, and I think there's some dialogue that I skipped. And all their red, yellow, and blue Pikmin, they're confused. He's like, why didn't you order us to move that old couch? That was right. That was like less than a centimeter right in front of your base. I know I could blast off. I don't need the darn couch to make it. Nope. Ship's just upset slightly, in the slightest. And it's just not good enough. Darn. Something tells me I really needed that couch just to take off. Well, that's a big shame. Oh well. Just gonna go ahead and save and show what's after us crashing. Because our life support systems failed and... Yeah, we're dead. No joke, we're dead. Like, no air for Olimar, or whatever he breathes. It's not oxygen, because he thinks that's poisonous. So, the one time when the Pikmin themselves do it, it actually works. But when we do it to ourselves, yep. So now Olimar becomes the Pikmin. He's now reborn as a true leader, one with the Pikmin. And now let's, assume that I still have my save file, right? Where's my save file? There it is. Okay, so now, the next thing I would like to do is, just do the same thing, but collect the ship part and then end the day. Because the way I have it set up is that I can't... there's no way where I can get all the ship parts. I could just bring back the couch and that's it. I can't bring back the... the piggy bank thing. The secret safe or what? Or that one part from you get from Emperor Boblax in the final trial. No way to get that because we're on day 30 and we have to spend another day just to get there. So he has no the drill. And just the fact that we're coming up on... for this playthrough, I initially started this playthrough back in July of 2011. So yeah, and in less than, I don't know, like around 3 months from now, we should be able to celebrate the 5-year anniversary of my playthrough of this game. So time flies, whether it be your voice gets deeper, just like you're here listening to right now, or just the other games that I did a playthrough on after I did the playthrough of this game. So, one thing I also could mention is that I jumped on the same geyser again. But I also would like to go over the slight differences in between the GameCube version and the new Play Control Wii version. I think, let me see if I can... Nope. So I'm going to have to just skip the... This is like a set of dialogue that plays, but I'm more than not enough patient to just wait out the clock up there. So I'm just going to let Olimar fall again. I like Olimar, but I don't want to kill him like that. But finally getting to the differences between both versions. To my knowledge, aside from the... What is it? The day rewind feature in the new Play Control version... And that option being absent in the GameCube version, the Boblax sounds, or the Bulborb sounds and the Dwarf Bulborb sounds are different compared to this version, because they have an entirely different sound. Not seen in any other versions of Pikmin, where it be in Pikmin 2, because they brought back the sound in the Pikmin 2 Wii, or Pikmin 2 in the Wii version. But for this. They're somewhat silent. They only make a little sudden noises in this specific version of Pikmin. Alright, so we got it all except for our piggy bank. So, all is well in the normal ending. We're able to escape, lift off. Didn't get everything, but we're able to just blast away. Oh my goodness, the normal ending is all but more similar to the best ending that you get if you collect all 30 ship parts. So you're not missing out on much if you get all of them. Maybe just like a special cutscene that's skipped if you just get the normal ending. Okay, so I finally got the two endings out of the way that I would like to get, and so now I would like to just take a quick visit into the challenge mode. It'll be the next thing I would like to do. As soon as we're done with the credits. Or if I can't skip the credits, then I'll have to make another drawing cut. Or I could just go over the Wii version staff credits. Because, you know, we gotta go over every little spec there is in this game. Because, why not? I have access... Or I was able to record both versions of this game. GameCube version and now the Wii version. Really a cool thing to do. Chances are I won't find myself doing that for Pikmin 2 because the GameCube version is still hella rare, and you're better off just sticking with the Wii version because there's not much you're missing out on the GameCube version, unless if you want to throw Pikmin incredibly fast in the GameCube version of Pikmin 2, but nah, it's just nothing to cry over like spilled milk. So okay, I can't skip the, what should we call it, the credits. No, it's not the happy ending, it's just the end. I was just able to return to the Hokotate Freight And in preparations for the sequel for the Pikmin, it's just Pikmin 2. But, you know, I've already done my playthrough of Pikmin 2. And if I were to go back to it, it'd be for that game's challenge mode. But for right now, let's go to the first game's challenge mode. As if we're going to go anywhere else. No, we're going to go to the challenge mode for Pikmin 2. I think I did touch on this a little bit in the last part, but I'd like to actually go into it. I think I don't have the final trial unlocked because shortly before all this recording, or all the recording for this, I had to play through the entire game again because I didn't have a save file for the Wii version of this game on my Wii U. So I had to go ahead and play that. I think I deleted my Wii version Pikmin save file. Just to try to make room for some other games, especially the download games. Ugh, back then, that's something we had to deal with back then. Was for the Wii hard drive, we just couldn't fit that many. Games and content on our systems. We had to either just get an SD card and put it all on there, or we just had to delete some things that we didn't want to get rid of. And so I'm not gonna just go around here. I'm just gonna walk around here like this and just give you an idea on what the challenge mode is like. But if I didn't mention this already, but in the last part, which is like 5 years ago, but the goal of challenge mode is to simply just sprout as many Pikmin as you can. And knowing that I sprouted just way too many Pikmin back in my initial playthrough, that's sounds like something that I would really enjoy. But yeah, strange enough, like in Mario Kart, where I like to like time trial my way in races with the Master Guys. I oddly don't actually play the time trials itself. Same kind of goes with this, where I sprout a lot of Pikmin in the main story, but I don't actually sprout the amount of Pikmin in the end game, or not the end game, but like the challenge mode that is specific for it. If that makes any sense, and you can make whatever it is to that. But I would like to just go around and just do this for all the maps, but I think that'd get really repetitive. But I might make a few notes on specific maps, like either the Impact Site, Forest of Hope, or Final Trial. I'll make a few notes if there's anything in those specific areas that you have to just worry about. So yeah, it's not much to this. There's a few enemies that normally don't appear during the main area, or the main story of Pikmin, like the Mamuda, supposed to be in the Impact Site. And then there's that puff stool that's supposed to be in the forest navel. So yeah, there's not much else that I could show off. So relatively short part compared to what I've been usually doing. So yeah, that's going to be it for Pikmin. It's all there is to show from the Wii version on sides. Also, and the additional endings that you get, depending on how many ship parts you get. So I'll meet you guys back here, I'll just meet you guys back, I think the same time, 1 p.m, as we're going to be continuing Paper Mario the Thousand Year Door and beginning Chapter 5. So till then, I'll see you guys later for that.